Well, hey, everybody. Welcome back to week number 4 in our Heroes of the Bible virtual Sunday school. Shep and I are very excited. I'm particularly excited because I'm wearing a crown today because we're thinking about a hero who was a queen, Queen Esther. Well, this is going to be a great lesson as we think about how Esther became the queen and how she used her power for good. Now, remember, heroes of the Bible, Moses was very brave when he was not sure that he could do what God asked him to do. Remember, Ruth was very loyal to her mother-in-law. And last week, we thought about Joseph, who was very forgiving, even when his brothers didn't treat him well. Well, today is Queen Esther, and I'm very excited to tell you a story that sometimes we skip over. We don't think about this one as much. So this is going to be great fun. Let's find out what we need for our Sunday school lesson on Queen Esther. The first thing you're going to need is the packet with the pink dot. Today is pink dot day. We don't really need anything extra for today. You always need markers and a pencil because we've got some fun little worksheets and a coloring sheet in there. Today, I have 2 Bibles with me. So you might want to grab your Bible. And if you have this one from when you were younger, you might want to see if you can find that one as well, because we're going to look at Queen Esther in that one as well. And of course, we need our Legos. So go ahead and grab those things, get your things all together while we sing a song that helps us to remember that this is the day that the Lord has made. Let's rejoice and be glad in it. Well done. I told Shep he could wear the crown, but I hope you sang along because this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. I hope you will too. Well, it's time to find our Bible story for today. And this is, like Ruth, Esther has her own book in the Bible. This one's a little harder to find. So I want to sing the song all the way to Esther that'll help us to find the book of Esther in our Bibles. You know, you can always use the table of contents in the very beginning that will help you find the books, but let's sing this together and see if we can find where Esther fits in the Bible. Ready? Genesis, Exodus, Leviticus, Numbers, Deuteronomy, Joshua, Judges, Ruth, 1st and 2nd Samuel, 1st Kings, 2nd Kings, 1st and 2nd Chronicles, Ezra, Nehemiah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs. Ah, Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs. That's a really good clue because I don't know if you know this, but if you open your Bible right to the middle, you're almost always going to be in either Psalms or Proverbs. If you just open it right to what looks like the middle. So if you remember, it was Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs. So find the middle and then go backwards to the book of Esther. Esther, Job, Psalms, Proverbs. You see what I'm using for a bookmark? Well, Esther has her own book in the Bible, and it tells all about this young woman and how she came to be the queen of Persia. Now, just for fun, I'm going to read you this story from this Bible. It's also in there. If you have this Bible around, it's on page 240. But this is the story of Queen Esther and how she came to power. Esther was Jewish. That means she was an Israelite. She lived in the land of Persia with her older cousin Mordecai. Some say it might have been her uncle, but she lived there with him. Her parents had died, and so uncle or cousin Mordecai took her in. The king of Persia needed a new queen. He announced, "Bring me the most beautiful women from all over the kingdom." Esther was one of the women sent to the palace. When the king met Esther, he chose her to be his queen. How exciting. Now, Haman was the king's chief helper. He worked for the king. He hated the Jewish people. No one knew that Mordecai and Esther were Jewish. They were God's people. Haman wanted everyone to bow down to him. Well, Mordecai refused to bow down to Haman. Mordecai would only bow to God. Haman went to the king and he said, "The Jews are bad people. You should sign a law that will help us get rid of them." So the king signed the new law, and God's people were in great danger. Well, Mordecai heard about this new law. He ran to tell Esther. Remember, she's the queen already. "You must save yourself and the rest of God's people. Perhaps God has made you the queen for this reason." So Esther came up with a plan. It would be very risky for her. Esther invited the king and Haman to a special dinner. See, she wasn't allowed to go see the king unless he invited her in, but she took a chance. Then she asked the king, "Why does Haman want to get rid of me?" Well, the king was surprised. She said, "I am Jewish. Haman tricked you into signing a law that would get rid of all the Jewish people." Well, the king told the guards, "Arrest Haman." And then he made Mordecai his new chief helper. He told Queen Esther, "I will make a new law that will keep you and your people safe." God used Esther to save his people. Isn't that interesting? Esther and Mordecai were Jews. They lived in Persia. Esther became the new queen of Persia. Haman, the chief helper for the king of Persia, didn't like the Jewish people, tricked the king into making a law so that they would wipe out the Jewish people. Mordecai found out about it, told Esther, she took a chance, told the king, all was well for the Jewish people. didn't end so well for Haman. Remember, he was trying to trick them anyway. Well, that's the story of Queen Esther. I found it for us in a couple different ways, but here's a fun cartoon. Now, watch carefully and see if you see anything that you remember from the story I just told you, or maybe you'll find something a little different. Watch this.
The land of Babylon was ruled by the king of Persia. But God's people were still living in Babylon. One of them was a young woman named Esther. The king of Persia wanted a beautiful young woman to be his queen. And he chose Esther. About this time, Esther's cousin Mordecai got in trouble.
Hey, Mordecai.
What?
Here comes General Haman. You better bow down to the leader of the king's army.
No, I will only bow down to the god of my fathers.
This made Haman so angry that he made a plan to kill all God's people living in Persia. Neither Haman nor the king knew that Queen Esther was related to Mordecai, or even that she was one of God's people. So the king agreed to Haman's evil plan. When Mordecai found out about the plan, he went secretly to visit the queen.
You must go to the king and beg him to have mercy on our people.
But I have not been called to the king. Anyone who enters his throne room without permission will be killed. Unless he holds out his gold scepter.
Yes, you may be killed. But who knows? You may have been chosen queen for just such a time as this.
The young woman had a big decision to make. One that could get her killed. Or it could save God's people.
All right. Tell all God's people to stop eating and start praying for me. I will go to the king, even though it is against the law. If I die, I die.
So Esther put on her royal robes and went to see the king. When the king's servants saw her, they were afraid she would be put to death. But when the king saw Esther, he was very pleased. Slowly, he held out his gold scepter.
What is it, my queen? What do you want to ask me?
My king, I ask that you have mercy on me and my people, the Jews. Haman wants us all to be killed.
And that day, the king decided to save Esther and all God's people from Haman's evil plan.
Well, there you have it. Esther, like Moses, was very brave, even when the situation was pretty dark. Well, let's take a look at what's in our packets for today and see what we have to help us remember the story of Esther. Well, if you open the packet, you'll notice that there's always some fun coloring sheets. There you see Queen Esther being welcomed by the king. Remember the Bible story? At least part of it is always on the back. This is a pretty fun puzzle, especially for your older kids, to find out what Queen Esther said. See if you can figure that one out. That one took me a little while. And then, of course, we have our Lego challenge, which we'll talk about in just a second. There's also something pretty fun that looks kind of familiar if you look around the screen here. Looks like this, but then there's also this. Fun little stickers that you can use to turn your plain crown into a sparkly crown. And you'll notice the Bible verse is right on there. So you make your own crown. You can be a king or a queen for a day. Pretty exciting. And then, how cool is this? I found a coloring book that tells the whole story. And so you can just read along like a comic book if you like, or you can take some time and do a little bit of coloring as you read the whole story of Queen Esther. Well, what's our Lego challenge for today? Hey, by the way, you guys made some excellent pyramids last week when we talked about Joseph and Egypt. Today's challenge is to make a crown. Now, it seems to me we've got plenty of crowns, but then the other is to make a throne or a scepter. A scepter is the pole, the rod that the king holds. Well, I did the best I could. I kind of think I did pretty good with this one. There is actually Queen Esther on her throne. I can't wait to see what you come up with. You are truly impressing me with your Lego creations. Well, I found another animation. I've never seen this done before. I think it's very, very clever. Watch to see how they draw the figures and tell the story of Queen Esther. So get busy on some of these crafts, but keep your eyes on the screen a little bit because you got to check out how clever this is as we see in another way the story of Queen Esther.
God's story, Esther. So part of God's story is about a woman named Esther, and it goes like this. Esther was adopted by her cousin, Mordecai, because her parents died. She and Mordecai were Jews, which means they were part of God's special family. Our story begins right before Esther becomes queen, and God's family gets in some serious danger. Now, even though Esther was a Jew, she lived in Persia, which was ruled by King Xerxes. Let's just call him X. One night, King X wanted to show off his wife, Queen Vashti, at a party. She said no. So he said Vashti could never see him again. And he needed a new queen. So the king invited all the single ladies in Persia to his palace for a year. He decided Esther was prettiest. And she became queen. Really? But as crazy as that sounds, it was a good choice because Esther saved his life. See, one day, Mordecai overheard two guards plotting to kill the king. So, he told Esther, and Esther told X. Around the same time, another powerful man at the palace, Haman, got really mad at Mordecai. He didn't know Mordecai had saved the king's life, or that he was the queen's cousin. So, he made a rule that all Jews must die. Like we said, he was really mad. And the king let Haman make this rule because he had no idea that Mordecai or Esther were Jews. Well, all the Jews were heartbroken. But Mordecai thought maybe Esther could save them. She was queen, after all. Problem is, only a king could change laws. And anybody who even spoke to the king when he didn't want to listen could die, including Esther. But she was willing to try. She said, "If I die, I die." Talk about brave. So Esther visited the king. To her relief, he said, "What do you want? I'll give it to you." Esther had a plan. Politely, she invited King X and Haman to dinner. She had saved the king's life. Now she was making a special dinner for him? X liked that. He said, "Yes." That night, the king asked Esther what she wanted again. And again, Esther invited them to dinner. Haman was thrilled to be invited to dine with the king and queen, twice. But even with this special treatment, he knew he couldn't be truly happy until Mordecai was dead. So, he came up with a plan to kill him the next day. But that same day, the king realized that Mordecai had never been honored for saving him. So X asked Haman how to honor someone. Haman thought the king was going to honor him. Instead, he honored Mordecai. So Haman was already in a bad mood when he got to dinner, but his day went from bad to worse. See, Esther finally told the king that someone made a law to destroy her people. X was furious and asked, "Who dared to do such a thing?" Esther told him, "It was Haman." Then the king found out that Haman wanted to kill Mordecai too. Enraged, he ordered that Haman be killed. After that, King X told Mordecai to make a new law to save the Jews. The Jews honored Mordecai and celebrated with a feast. Esther had been willing to risk her life for her people, and she ended up saving them. Like Esther, another rescuer would come one day, and he would actually die to save all of God's special family. And that's the story of Esther. So, in case you missed it, here's the quick version. Esther was a Jew. She became queen. Mordecai overheard a plan. He told Esther. Esther told X. Mordecai made Haman mad. Haman made a law. The Jews were sad. Esther was brave. She had a plan. She told the king about Haman. The king got rid of Haman. God's family was saved. And that's a part of God's story.
Now, wasn't that clever? I've never seen anything like that before. I don't know how they did it, but I'm sure glad they did, because that was another fun way to hear the story. Well, Shep told me I could wear the crown again. We like to share and take turns, so it was my turn to wear the crown, but we're about out of time for today, so I hope you've had fun thinking about Queen Esther and a story maybe you didn't know before. So I encourage you to go back and read the whole story, the whole book of Esther, and see, especially you big kids, see the parts we might have skipped over to find out all that was going on in Persia during this time. It's actually quite an exciting story. So that's it for today. We want to talk to God and thank God for brave Queen Esther. I really do think Esther was in the right place at the right time for God to save his people yet again. So let's talk to God, we'll say our special prayer, and then we'll wrap it up for this lesson on Esther, my hero. Let's pray. God, we do thank you that you make us all brave, but today we especially thank you for Esther, the young Jewish girl, and how you helped her to be brave and to do hard things so that all of the people might be saved. Lord, help us to always be willing to look out for ways that we can help other people, and then give us the courage to do it. And now we'll pray together the prayer that Jesus taught us to pray, saying, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. All right, friends, it's a wrap for Queen Esther. Next week, we'll come back together and think about our hero, Daniel. But for now, I want you to keep singing, keep praying, keep reading your Bible, find the book of Esther, keep sending me those pictures. I just love it. And remember, God loves you. I love you. Have a great week, and I'll meet you right back here next week. Have a great time. Bye-bye.
Three long days. robes and went before the king. The king was so happy, he said he'd give her anything. Esther held two banquets and told him everything. The king was angry and asked, who would do such a thing? Who would do such a thing? Esther said that Haman was the man, the one who came up with the plan. Haman was terrified, he went pale with fright. The king ordered Haman killed on that night. That very night. But the plot was still in place, and the Jews were in harm's way. The king issued a decree, defend yourselves however you may. The Jewish people